Hi, it's Phil from Delphi Technologies. Now, in today's video, we're going to be replacing the brake fluid on this 2015 Tesla Model S. Now, to do this, we're going to need three things. We're going to need new brake fluid, we're going to need a pressure bleeder, and also a diagnostic tool. Right then, the bonnet's up, or the frunk, as Tesla like to call it. We need to just quickly remove the front apron. Now the apron's off, since we're doing a brake fluid replacement, we need to drain all of the fluid out of the reservoir as much as possible, so we're not pushing any old or dirty fluid through. So we've got our empty container there. We're going to remove the cap. And we're going to use a syringe, and we're going to pull out all of the old fluid first. And we simply keep going until all of the fluid has been extracted. We've extracted all the fluid from the car. You may hear from the car during this, as I just did, there was a beep, an error on the dashboard, which is only going to be for low brake fluid warning, since we've removed it all from that. So fill up the master cylinder now with fresh fluid, and then we can fit the pressure cap on. There we go. So you can see all the way to the brim. We want to try and remove as much air as possible from that. So we've attached the cap onto the master cylinder reservoir. They're all different types of adapters. We're having to use a universal on this one to make sure that we get that full seal. Next step is to attach the pressure bleeder directly onto this. We're going to be using the brake bleeder from Laser. Now on this particular brake bleeder, we have three connections. We have the fresh fluid connection, so that goes in the brake fluid bottle. 12 volt supply, where we're going to plug it into the cigarette lighter. And finally, the connection to the cap, which we've just fitted. Now on this, very simple to operate, and we're looking to set it here for this Tesla at 30 PSI, around about 2 bar, for pushing the fluid through before we activate it on the diagnostic tool. Wheels are off. Now, the question you might be wondering is, why are we using an axle stand on a four-poster ramp? And the reason for that is a lot of ramps now are struggling with electric vehicles because the beam jack that goes in the center of a four-post ramp, they can't spread wide enough to get to the designated lifting points because of electric vehicle battery sat in the middle of the vehicle. So if you can't get wide enough, then what we suggest is, of course, first contact your manufacturer of the ramp to see if they offer a wider beam jack. In this case, this ramp doesn't have that, so we're using an axle stand. We're still supporting on the designated lift points, so we're okay with that, but it would be easier and quicker to use a designated beam jack. So that's why we're using the axle stands in this video. Now, we're gonna get to the point now where we're ready to begin bleeding. So we're gonna get the pressure up to standard. Remember, it was 30 PSI in the brake bleeding tool. We're gonna get the diagnostic tool plugged in, so then we can activate the brake bleed procedure. We've got the pressure bleeder at 30 PSI. We're now ready to connect to the vehicle on the diagnostic tool, and this will take us through the process and importantly tell us which wheel we've got to start with. Traditionally, on all older cars, you'd always start at the wheel the furthest away from the master cylinder, but this has changed in recent years with newer vehicles. So the best thing is always check the data in the diagnostic tool. We're gonna go ahead and connect. We can type in the registration number. Now, if you do struggle on this with gloves, like I am now, that's why we supply the pen in the kit. So we've got all the vehicle details. We can see here that it's a Model S 2015 electric vehicle. We're gonna go ahead and go to the brake system and go to ABS. We're gonna communicate on diagnostics, nice and quick. We can see the connector location, if you're unsure. And we're gonna go and connect to the ECU. Now, once we've connected, we're going to go straight into activations, and the test we've got to perform, we've got the different ones here. That's the one we're interested in there, brake system, filling, and bleeding. Now, what's going to go through is go through all the prerequisites and why you must do this and when. Brake bleeding is performed in the following sequence: front left, front right, rear right, and then rear left. So we're going to work our way around that vehicle. So we can go ahead and begin the activation. Send the command to the brake ECU that we want to start. Is everything in all the park? Is the vehicle in park? Yes. Now, a little tip on Tesla, that you will often get bad communication if the vehicle isn't fully on. And Tesla call this activating the HV rail, the high voltage rail. To do that, quite simple, just simply put your foot on the brake pedal. You'll hear the ding ding as the car activates, and then it's ready for full communication. So remember, the dialogue box that comes up, Select the circuit we're going to bleed. So the instruction is there, the front left wheel first. So here we've got front left and rear right is on that middle one. So before we do that and actually do the final activation, I'm going to attach the brake bleeding equipment on. Now for this, we're using the laser toolkit because what we don't want to do is get any brake fluid on the nice painted calipers that are supplied on this vehicle. And the difference between these spanners is they have an inbuilt seal inside. So you can simply remove the brake dust cover. We can slot those over, slacken them on and off when we're bleeding, and none of the mess is going to come down the caliper. And that's the risk with just using a standard bottle on there. Now this particular vehicle's got four pot calipers. So we've got two pistons on the outside, two pistons on the inside. It's a fixed caliper. So you've actually got two separate bleed circuits. Now Tesla recommend always starting with the outer. You bleed the outer, then the inner, move on to the next wheel, outer and then the inner. So let's start off first. We're just going to remove the dust cap on both sides. So I've selected the 11 mil, the correct size for this vehicle. We're going to be using this tube here with a one-way valve, and you can see there's an arrow on the valve facing away from the caliper. So step one, we're going to fit that on. Remember, it's got an O-ring built inside. Step two, we'll put that on, and then we're ready to activate the function. So activate on the tool, the front left circuit. We have an activation time. How long do we want to activate it for? I'm going to do a full 15 seconds as we're changing the fluid. We can slacken that off and at the same time we activate the tool. And we tighten that back up. So the outer's complete. Time to now to move to the inner. We're going to activate the diagnostic tool again. We're going to do the same circuit and we're going to give it that full 15 seconds. Here we go. Excellent. Both sides now bled and flushed through. Let's move on to the driver's side and continue the procedure. Same procedure as before. We've checked the pressure, we've increased it back up, we're back to 30 psi. Out first, then onto the inner. We've removed the dust covers and it's basically followed the same procedure again. Attaching on the brake hose first, lock that in place. We're now ready to activate the diagnostic procedure and slacken that off. We're going to go the full 15 seconds. Right, it's complete, moving on to the inner. And we're ready to run the procedure. Now that's complete, we can refit the brake dust covers, making sure all the area is clean of any brake fluid. We would then simply follow the sequence in the diagnostic tool on the rear wheels, and that would complete that brake bleeding section of the job. Now both the rear wheels are done, we've disconnected the pressure bleeder and we can now remove the high pressure cap. So now what will happen, of course, is that the level will be too high. You can see that here. If I'm going to put this little light to be able to see, so you can see there, the level's going to be too high. So what we need to do is syringe it out until it's at that right level. So I'm going to bring back in my bottle and bring back the syringe, and we just want to take it until down until it's at the max level. Now a good idea to do this before, just before you do this, is to pump the pedal a few times just to allow the brakes to settle. They shouldn't really change. Do that first and then syringe it out until we drop that level down to the max. It's just at the max level now. So all that's left to do now is to refit the brake fluid cap, refit the apron, just to make sure as well, this is a high voltage vehicle, that this tag is out while you fit the apron. It's what the emergency services use to disable the vehicle if it's in an accident. So don't put it back in accidentally into here while you're refitting it. Thanks for joining me in replacing the brake fluid in this Tesla Model S. For more videos and tips, then why not follow us on social media or visit our Masters of Motion online hub. And for more expert-led training courses, then visit the Delphi Training Academy. Thanks for watching.